Let's see. So how to design application with PC based home automation. So if you want to control the loads by using microcontroller with the PC keyboard, so now we are preparing that application by using Keil and Proteus combination. So just double click on Keil Microvision. From here, just select project tab and choose the option new project. And this is our application, PC based home automation. And give your project name and click on save. And it will ask for selection of device from different manufacturers. So from here you can select your controller manufacturer as Atmel and click on plus mark. It will show the list of devices from this manufacturer and choose your specific microcontroller from this list, and it will show the internal features of this device. So the quantity of timers, interrupts, IO lines, memory, flash and all. After selection of your device, just click on OK. And this is a startup code warning. This startup code have all the default values of internal resistors. And just click on yes or no, there is no problem. And just click on no. So now our people created a project with a specific target device, which is from Atmel manufacturer, and device is 8089C51. And to write your embedded C program, you have to open editor window. To open editor, go file tab and choose the option new. And this is the text editor. Here you have to write our statements. Before going to write the program, try to save this one. To save the program, file and click on save. This is on this. Now save your file. Which is PC based home automation. And you have to save this file with .c extension compulsory. And click on save. Now our people can write our statements. And just write down, this is the header file. You have to include for all 51 families, which is reg51.h. Now do the declarations with a specific loads. Load 1, just connect with T1.0, and load 2, which is connected with T1.1. And load 3, which is connected with P1.2, and load 4, which is connected with P1.3. These are all loads connections we are giving with IO lines. and this is your void main. And now, so you have to establish the serial communication with microcontroller by using a standard steps. So by using setting the value of SCON register, which is 0x50, and you have to choose the timer 1 in mode 2, which is 0x20, and set the baud rate as 9600 by assigning TH1 as -3 and start your timer. So these are the fundamental steps you have to write for establishing serial communication with the microcontroller and peripheral. Now I will wait for a character you have to receive from keyboard by observing the status of RI. While RI equals to 0, this semicolon means if RI logic is 0, then stay there. If RI becomes 1, then go for next step. What is the next step you are following? So to receive the character from my PC to microcontroller, I am taking a temporary variable which is as x. So once RI becomes 1, then the data is ready on SBUF. Then the received data, just I am moving to temporary variable x, and you want to see which character you received. Again I am retransmitting by assigning the same character to SBUF. So these are the two steps to transmit a character from microcontroller to peripheral. So the received character, whatever I received from peripheral, which again retransmitting from controller to PC. So you have to clear this TI logic to receive the, to transmit the next character. So these are all fundamental steps you are looking to receive and receive the characters from PC keyboard. So based on receive character, so our people have to enter into the one infinite loop. So now the received character, which is present on x variable. So now I am writing the if conditions, the received based on received character. So I am going to turn on the loads. So if I am taking, if I am receiving the character L1, so just I will turn on my load 1 or relay 1. Suppose else if otherwise I can use nested if received character is 2, then I can change the logic of load 1 as 0. So the first 1 and 2 numbers I am using to operate load 1. So this is for load of, and this is load on. Next, 3 and 4 numbers, so I will use for load 2 if x is 3, then I will turn off load 2 if the received character is 4. Then load 2 is on. This is load 2 off. And for third load, just the received character is 5, then turn on load 3. And if the received character is 6, then load 3 is on. If the received character is 7, then you can turn on load 4. Next, if the received character is 8, these are all the conditions for operating the loads based on the received character from keyboard. So this is the complete program for operating the loads based on the characters from PC keyboard. And if you want to compile this program, just select Project Workspace window and click on Target 1. And click the plus mark, you will get source group 1. right click it and go for the option add files to source group 1 and choose your specific file and click on add. And you can check out whether file is added or not by click on this plus mark. And to see the errors and warnings of your program, select project tab and click on build target. And one more closing brace required. And if you do any modifications, save and build. This is the complete program for operating loads by based on the received character from keyboard. And if you want to see this thing in with hardware simulation by using Proteus, select target one and right click and go for the option options for target one. And give the frequency as 11.0592 and highlight this use on chip ROM, and in the same window choose output tab and highlight this create hex file option and click on OK and go project tab and build once. So once you build the program, it will show the hex file path for your project and minimize your development tool and just double click on this Proteus simulation tool and choose the devices from this library just by click on this P symbol and type your specific microcontroller and choose the device. If you double click it, it will come into the list. And for connecting loads, so I will use animated relay model, which is SPST. And for loads connection, as a source, we are using AC source, which is alternator. You have to choose alternator from the list and take the bulbs or lamp. If you double click it, it will come into the list. Now close this pick devices window and choose this microcontroller and now do this relay connections. And all general relays are available with 12 volts rating. And take AC source with the combination of load. So for one relay, you people can connect one load. And take one end source as common for all these relays. And this for this DC relays, just connect source from terminals mode and choose power connection one end, and make sure all relays one end should be connected with the source. And the other ends of relay lines, you have to make it logic 0 by connecting with microcontroller IOs. So these are the standard connections required to operate the relays. And source, the other end which is contacted with the relay drive pin, and this source, AC source, other end will be driven through relay, and here this is NC and this is NO, and all these NO lines which are connected with the other terminals of other ends of loads. And all these relays which are 12 volts operated, and whenever you are looking to interface with microcontroller, just make them 5 volts characteristics, because your microcontroller which is operated with 5 volts DC. So these relays are available with different rating from the market, which is 5 volts, 12 volts, 24 volts, 9 volts. So based on our requirement, our people can choose any rating relay from the market. So here you have to give 5 volts for all these relays. And now for allowing the characters from keyboard, so you have to connect serial window, it will from virtual instruments mode, and choose your virtual terminal, and do the cross connections with RXD with TXD line. And here RXD line with TXD. So after giving your all hardware connections, just double click on controller. So it will ask for program file path, and click on this folder symbol. It will ask for hex file path. Choose your hex file from your saved window and click on open, and give the same clock frequency as 11.0592. Click on OK. And now, so the initial status of all relays and all loads which are in off state. If I am giving 2 from the keyboard, you can see the response from your load 1, which should be off, and just will verify the program. Which is continuously receiving, So just make it clear your RI status to allow the next character. Save the program and build once. If you do any modification in the program, save and build. Now you can see the changes with your application. To turn on first one, give the input as 2. Now the load, you can observe here, your load is turned on. And by giving input 1 from keyboard, the load 1 status is off. And if you want to turn on load 2, you can give the character 4 from your keyboard. And to turn off the second load, you can give 3. You can find out relay switching here by giving the input from keyboard. And if you want to see the response from load 3, just give 6 as a number and 5 for load 3 off. 6 5 6 5. You can see the relay switching over here. And for operating fourth load, to turn on load you have to give 8 to turn on and 7 for off. And if you want to operate all loads on at a time, so just stop this. And you can write one more condition for operating all loads on, all loads off. If x is 0, you can turn on, you can turn off all loads at a time. And if you are giving input as 9 from the keyboard, you can turn on all the loads at a time. And if you do any modification, save and build. Now you can see the changes according to your program. If you are giving 0, all loads will be off. If you are giving 9, all loads will turn on. And for operating individual, you can use individual buttons, whatever you assigned in the program. All odd numbers for on and even numbers for off. And to turn off all loads, you can use 0. To turn on all the loads, you can use 9. So this is the way you people can control your loads by using PC personal computer. And this is the complete application for PC based home automation system by using microcontroller, 8051 microcontroller with Keil and Proteus combination. This is the way you people can design applications by using Keil and Proteus combination. Thanks for watching.